Hello and welcome.
Hola y bienvenido.
Hallo und willkommen.
Bonjour et bienvenue.
Zoom's language interpretation feature allows you to connect with your meeting or webinar participants in multiple languages. Your participants will be able to select their desired language channel and hear both the original and interpreted audio. In this video, you'll learn how to enable the language interpretation feature, add interpreters, and manage interpretation in your meeting or webinar, and how your participants can listen to their language channel of choice. Before we begin, here are some things to know about language interpretation. Language interpretation cannot be used in meetings using your PMI, or personal meeting ID, nor can it be used in instant meetings. It can only be used in scheduled meetings where you have selected Generate Automatically for the meeting ID. For webinars, those added as an interpreter must also be a panelist. And we recommend avoiding sharing your computer audio while you're using language interpretation. The computer audio will broadcast at full volume, thereby causing some audio imbalance. First, log into your Zoom web portal at zoom.us and navigate to Settings from the left menu. Go to the In Meeting Advanced section and locate Language Interpretation. Click the toggle to enable or disable the feature. Here, you can also choose to enable language interpretation by default for any meeting or webinar you schedule. There are 9 default languages available, but you can add custom languages by clicking the plus sign. You can add as many as you like, but once you're in your meeting or webinar, you can only choose up to 5 of the custom languages. If you need more than 5 custom languages in your meeting, please contact support. Next, to add an interpreter to your meeting, you will need to schedule a meeting and be sure to select Generate Automatically for the meeting ID. Towards the bottom, you'll find Interpretation. Enter your interpreter's email address and then choose the appropriate languages for that interpreter. Save your meeting. You can click Edit under the Interpreter section to add interpreters, resend the email invitation, copy the invitation, or remove the interpreter. If you added an interpreter, remember to click Save. If you are scheduling a webinar instead, the process is the same as it is for meetings. Schedule a webinar and follow the same steps. Once you launch your meeting or webinar, you'll click on Interpretation to initiate the interpretation sessions. You'll be able to add additional interpreters from here. When ready, click Start to start the interpretation session. Your interpreters and participants can now click Interpretation in the meeting controls and select a language channel. The host can click on Interpretation to end the interpretation session or to click on Manage Language Interpretation to make changes to the interpreter settings. Interpreters can only select the language channel to which they are assigned. They will hear the original meeting audio, which they can translate. Participants will select their language channel and will hear the translated audio as well as the original audio at a lower volume so they can hear tone and intonation for greater understanding. However, participants can choose mute original audio to hear only the interpreter. Note for both interpreters and participants, you must be joined by a computer audio to participate in the interpretation session. It is not available to telephone dial-in users. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.